OnSong keeps your repertoire of lyrics, chord charts, and sheet music organized and ready to perform by you or your band. Annotations let you highlight the things you need when you're on stage. The drawing add-on lets you use your finger or a stylus to mark up your songs. To use the drawing tool, tap on the sticky note icon in the menu bar to open the annotations menu. This menu lets you add sticky notes to a song or to access the drawing tool. Tap on the drawing option. You'll see the drawing bar appear over the menu bar. The drawing bar is divided into four sections. On the left are the pan, pen, highlighter, and eraser tools. Next, we have a slider, which is used to adjust the size of the tool. Next, we have the color picker, which lets us quickly pick from a palette of preset or custom colors. The last section lets us undo, redo, and save our changes. On the far left is the pan tool. We can tap on this to select it, and then we can tap and drag in the song viewer to scroll or zoom to where we want to draw. The pen tool can be used to draw like you would using a pen or pencil. You'll see the brush size of the pen starts at 3 points. We can tap and drag on the size slider to change the size of the pen. As we draw, you'll notice the pen has a rounded shape, as we would expect from a drawing implement like this. I'm going to tap on a different color in the color picker and draw something else. Pretty easy. We can use color to communicate different things. Just like a basic box of crayons, you get 9 colors. But if you swipe over, you'll find a plus button. We can tap on this to create a custom color. The color builder menu is displayed. Here we can choose a hue from this slider at the bottom, and then adjust the brightness and saturation of the color up here. I'm going to make a teal color, and then use this opacity slider on the right to make it about 50% opaque. When I tap done, the color is added to my palette and selected. If I think I'm going to access that color a lot, I can tap and hold for a second and then drag the color towards the beginning of the palette. Maybe some of these colors are just getting in your way, like this white color. Just tap and drag it outside of the palette and release it to delete it from the presets. The white color is included because you can use it to erase parts of a PDF or other externally imported file. However, on text-based documents, all your drawings will appear under the text for readability. Let's draw some more. Okay, let's say we really don't like the way that looks. We can undo it by tapping on the undo button right here. If we accidentally undo something and want to put it back, we tap on the redo button, like this. Got it? A common function is to highlight lyrics or chords for a certain part of the song. When we tap on the highlighting tool, our palette changes to a semi-transparent preset, and the brush size changes too. Each brush remembers its last size. Let's highlight a line. That looks okay, but it's really hard to make a straight line. Luckily, our tools have a trick up their sleeve. Let's tap on the highlighter tool again, and we see a straight line appears in the tool icon. This means we are now in ortho mode. Now when we draw, we'll see our line is perfectly horizontal. But if we draw a diagonal line, it will be straightened out from the start to the end as well. OnSong will snap to perfectly horizontal or vertical lines if we get close to one. We could change the threshold for determining this by tapping and holding on the tool icon that supports straightening, and then setting it with this slider. All of the drawing tools except pan can be put in straightening mode, including our next one. Let's say we don't like some of the things that we've drawn. Right next to the highlighter tool is the eraser. With this, we can remove parts of this drawing we don't want anymore. Just tap and adjust the size of the eraser, and then draw to erase what we want. Each time we switch the tool, change the brush size, or the color, we are starting a new layer. When we undo, we're actually removing layers from our drawing. You can view this list of layers to do some more advanced things, so let's take a look. Tap on the layers icon here to open the layers menu. each layer shows the tool, color, and size that was used. And over here on the right, you'll see a check mark. This means that the layer is currently visible. We could toggle layers on and off by tapping on the row. One way this can be useful is if we name our layers. So tap on the edit button up here, and then tap on the name of the layer to rename it. You can then use this to toggle parts of the drawing on and off depending on how or who is playing the song. If we go back into edit mode, you'll see a reordering handle as well. We can change the order of our layers. So for instance, I can drag this pen to be on top of the highlight. We can even move our eraser layer to determine what it erases. Of course, instead of using the eraser, it may be easier just to delete certain layers in here instead. This is a great way to start over, but maybe save something that you really like. Speaking of saving, when we're all done, we tap on this check mark on the far right to save our changes. And then we go back to viewing our chord chart. Again, you'll notice that our drawings will go under our text to be more realistic to real life. If you're using an iPad Pro with an Apple Pencil, the drawing tool becomes even easier to access. Just tap on the screen with your Apple Pencil and you're immediately in drawing mode. You can then draw away or pick a different tool. If you touch the screen with your finger, the pan tool is automatically selected. And then when you draw with the Apple Pencil, the drawing tool is selected and the input is more accurate too. If you want to draw something with your finger, just choose the drawing tool to override the pan tool. And if you don't like this integration, you can go into the layers menu and turn it off using this switch at the bottom. There are a few things you'll want to know about how the drawing tool works that may help you with its usage. First, if you're viewing a PDF file, Word document, or some other imported file that's not text-based, the drawing is applied on top of the document. That means the drawing is placed on top of any text, so you can use the white pen to erase things in a PDF file, for instance. If you're drawing in a text-based document, like using the OnSong format or Chord Pro, the drawing appears under the text. Text-based chord charts in OnSong can be fluid and can be formatted differently depending on your preferences. This can cause issues with drawings. For instance, if you change the size of the font in a song, or if you toggle chords on and off, or alter the flow of the song, the drawings will no longer align with where you put them originally. This is because the size and layout of the page is changing. So just keep that in mind if you're going to make changes to a song later. If you want to highlight certain parts of your song that will stick with the text, try using line formatting. I hope that gives you some idea of how the drawing add-on can help annotate your chord charts in OnSong. If you have any questions, be sure to contact us at onsongapp.com/support.